Welcome to video. In this lecture, we're going to learn the different line support and line insulators from unit number 5, the components of transmission and distribution line. So after completion of this topic, student will be able to understand the different components of overhead transmission system, different sketches of line supports and insulators, and different methods of line erections. So different components of overhead transmission systems are the conductors, line support, insulators, cross arms, stay sets, ground wires, lightning arrester, fuses and isolating switches. So then we'll see the one by one line conductors. Basically, for the transmission and distribution purpose, the different line conductors are of copper, aluminium, ACSR, that is the aluminium conductor, steel reinforced, GI, galvanized steel conductor, cadmium copper, AAA conductor, that is all aluminium alloy conductors, and ASC, that is aluminium stranded conductors. These are to be used. So different line supports are the wooden poles. Wooden poles are of basically two types, the single wooden pole, A and H type wooden pole, steel poles, RCC, that is reinforced cement concrete pole, steel towers, these are again two types, single circuit and double circuit. So we'll see the diagram of wooden pole, that is the single pole wooden pole circuit. In this diagram, we are going to clearly observe the pin insulator is to be placed at the top of this pole, and this is another type. So this is the cross arm. Okay, so this is the another type of wooden pole type having the A and H type structure. So this shape is look like a A, and again this is look like a H. Then so this is the pictorial view of steel tower. In that case, in left hand side we are going to observe there is a single circuit, and on the right hand side we are going to observe there is a double circuit transmission tower. Basically, poles are used for the distribution purpose point of view, and towers is used for the transmission purpose point of view. The different types of insulators are the pin insulator, disc insulator, suspension type insulator, strain insulator, shackle insulator and stay insulator. We will see one by one in detail. Before that, the electrical properties of insulating materials are, it should have the high resistance, it should have the high breakdown voltage, it should have the high dielectric strength, and it should have the low dielectric loss. So at the same time, it should have the low dielectric constants. So transmission line and distribution line insulating materials are porcelain glass polymers. So porcelain and the polymer nowadays most widely used. Polymer is used because the polymer is light in weight compared to the porcelain one. So this is the picture of pin insulator. Here we are going to observe this structure. So at the pin insulator, at the top groove portion is to be there. So in this place, we are going to hold the conductor like this in picture. Okay, so with the help of that, we can place the wire in at the top of this groove. So this is the picture of 11 kV pin insulator. So this is the picture for the 33 kV pin insulator. Same structure is to be there, little bit change. And this is the picture for the 66 kV. This is used for the this is the picture of pin insulator again, and used for the 66 kV supply. Next we move toward the disc type insulators. In this picture we are going to see how disc insulator look like. So forming a number of discs, approximately one disc will provide the means withstand the voltage around 11 kV. So depending upon the level of your voltage, number of discs is to be increased. So increasing the number of discs, we are going to form a string. So when number of discs will be connected in this way, they are going to form a string. So this is the picture of one of the transmitting tower. Dual transmission is to be there, and this is string is to be going observed. So with the help of that, suspension type is another one. So for the forming of this we are going to use this suspension type insulator. Suspension type insulator is going to most widely used in the transmission purpose point of view. So with the help of that, we can also achieve the voltage around 765 kV. So it means what? With the help of this string, we can achieve the maximum voltage. 765 means 765 voltage is to be withstand by that particular line. Then this is the strain insulator. Strain insulator is specially used where the line take a turn, means specially on the crossing reverse, or where the line get turns, at that point we are going to use the strain insulator. So in this figure we are going to understand the consisting of three suspension type insulators is connected in this way, and line jumper is to be formed here. So this is line jumper, and again this line is going to be passed here. So for that purpose we are going to use the strain insulators. Okay, so same concept, same phenomenon is used. We are going to form the 765 kV voltage. Next insulator is of shackle type insulator. Shackle type insulator is used where the we have to require the termination of line. So this is the structure how shackle insulator is to be connected. So at the top of pole we are going to place the round washer. This is of MS, and the clamp for the insulator, and here we are going to place the insulator with the help of nut and bolts. So shackle insulator is look like. So in this figure we are going to observe how this shackle insulator is to be look. Then stay insulator. In the stay insulator, especially in this type of insulator, there is no presence of voltage. So this times this may use as a egg type insulator. So with the help of one example we can easily understand where stay insulator is to be placed. Let us consider one pole is to be there. So where line is going in this way. So what will happen? This pole there may be a chances of bending. So to avoid this, we are going to provide some additional support with the help of this line. So on that case, we are going to use this stay insulator. So this is the mechanism where stay insulator is to be. In normal working condition, there is no voltage present over this stay insulator, but during the abnormal condition, there is presence of voltage over this stay insulator. So these are some additional insulator, real insulators and brake insulators. So we'll see the methods of erection of pole, how sequence is to be followed. So first step is that the preparation of erection depends upon the type of pole, which is then prepare a pit of given marking. Then size of pit should be 2.5 feet to 2 feet, and the depth of pit is 1/6 of pole height. Suppose pole height is of 6 meter, then we are going to put a distance 1/6 of pole height. That means 1 meter is inside. So rest of the pole on the channel smooth and gradual erection. Then erect the pole in the prepared pit using accessories and sufficient manpower. Nowadays machinery is to be used for the erection of pole. After erection of pole, checking the alignment before the concrete. And now pouring the concrete in the ratio of 1:4:2 is in the pole pit. So this is the pictorial view how we are going to put the inserting the pole. And this information is collected from the internet. So this is the assignment for all of you. So please solve this assignment and email me. Thank you.